Good tie, flashtail whistler. Extremely popular pipe fly. So get asked about how to tie it and materials, etc. quite often. So here we go. Thread I'm using, 110 denier, Vanyards Dyneema. Hook and device is a Partridge Universal Predator X in a 4-0. You can use the standard wire, but I prefer the X. This says 6-0, but the hook I've got in the device is actually a 4-0. Nice and strong. So, let's get going. Attach your thread. Take it down to a point opposite the barb of the hook. Snip off your waist. And as ever, with these gel spuns, Dyneemas, etc. A wee bit of glue just to help it grip. I also like to add a little bit of wax onto the gel spun Dyneema, etc. to give it a wee bit of grip on the materials, because it can slip quite bad. Just going to take it round the bend a touch and back up. Next thing we're going to use for the tail, and the key ingredient for this fly, much like the sparkler, is silver flashaboo. Use tons of this stuff. Be quite generous with it. Take a full length off the hank. But about that much is about right. Snip that off. Bit like the sparkler. I'm about 2/3 of the way up that length. And snip that off. Keep that. Back to your hank. Just spread it out and just tease out some of the strands just to taper it. Straighten up the other side. It saves you hacking away at the flash with taperizing scissors after. Wet it a wee bit. Makes it easy to control. About 60-40 split. Pinch your loop, pull up. I like to keep the tail on top of the hook to help minimize tangling. It's really good sturdy turns with this. Half a dozen turns. Grab your wee push tool and push that back. And much like it did with the sparkler, I like to actually bind it down top of itself. Good hard turns. Just get a tapered tail. Go back to your other third off cut. Just take your time with this. Again, rough it up a wee bit, taper it out a wee bit, and offer that up right in front of that wee bump. Couple of loose turns under bobbin weight. Use your thumb to spread it round. Couple of tight turns on the spot. Push tool again, push it back. This time, bring it in front, just to help with the volume this time. Just build up a wee ramp in front of the flash. Just make sure it behaves itself. And I like to put a little bit of contrasting flash down the side or something, just a wee bit different. So I'll just take two strands of this holographic silver. Double it up. snippet. Offer it up and just tie it in laterally. Hold that back. So on the other side, don't need to be crazy neat with this. Don't really care, the pipe don't care either. Okay, so that's you got your the main ingredient for the Whistler, which is the flash tail. That holds out the way. Sorry about the quality of this, it's filmed on my phone. I'm not too bothered about having super fancy edits or anything like that. Just as long as you can see how the fly gets tied. Right, next stage is some bucktail. This is some nice bucktail from Vineyard. Got to select a fairly generous bunch for the middle of the tail. Straighten it up is, again, you don't need to be crazy neat with this. Take out the fluff at the bottom. We're not going to reverse tie this, we're just going to tie it in standard straight on in front of the flash. Now we want it to go back about halfway along the tail. So I'm going to offer that up, pinch and loop. 1, 2, 3. Okay, I'm just keeping weight on that bobbin while I use my thumb to spread that around and just tighten up. You can cover up those buttons. Again, just make sure you're giving that plenty of pull, because you don't want these pulling out in the first jackpot you catch. So again, come back to the glue. Respotting that. A few more securing wraps. You can, if you like, build up this body with some hackle flash or whatever. It's not crazy essential. You know, give it a wee bit of something in the core of the fly. It's not essential. You can just come up the fly, much like a hollow fly. Kind of a mil, 15 mil, 10 mil, 15 mil, something like that. And then this time, I'm going to take another section of bucktail. Prepare it the same way. Take crap out. Exchange grips, because this time we're going to hollow tie it. Shorten it a touch. Offer it up to the shank of the hook. Use your left hand or however you feel comfortable. It's two or three kind of bobbin weight turns. Again, keeping tension. Offering that round and then come in. Tighten up. I'm supporting the hook with my thumb. I'm pushing in the opposite direction that I'm pulling with the thread, so that I don't bend the hook and rip it out the vise. Now we're going to obviously double this back and butt it up against this section here. You could leave them if you want, but I find it a wee bit neater just to drop these ends off a wee bit. And you can be neater if you want. bit of wax for the next stage before we bring it through onto your Dyneema. What I'm also going to do is just put a couple of secure wee drops of glue in there. Don't want these getting chewed up, falling apart. Right, push tool, push your bucktail back, control it with your left hand, bring the thread forward and under, and do that damn thread again. Don't keep that dab too short, otherwise the thread will just slip down on itself. Build up a cone, just check. Just try and get the profile that you're at, you're looking for. Yeah, so it's starting to slip a wee bit already. Back to the wax. Yeah, clip that back out of the way. Right. Next thing we're going to put in is a little bit of lateral scale flash down the side. I do this just again, just full length, one strand on each side, doubled back. So one on my side. Double it back. And clip. And a second strand for the far away side. Go under the thread. Find the centre point and catch it down. Back into the clip. More wax again. Next thing I'm going to add in, I don't use Grizzly anymore. I do occasionally if someone wants it, but I'm going to put in this Vedyard Bard Long Ostrich. A lot cheaper and nice and mobile. Yeah, it's a lot cheaper. So I'm going to take out four feathers for each side, and again lengthwise about the total length of the bucktail, so halfway along the flash tail. Bit of a pigeon loop on my side, another three or four feathers, snip it off. Same on your side. Okay, this just gives a wee bit of something to break up the plain white with the bucktail, so it's scales or bars or something or other. I'm also going to add just a little bit of plain white ostrich over the top, again just to give a bit of volume. Catch it in. You double these back and tie it down if you want. Ostrich is quite strong, so I don't find you have to tidy up these butts a wee bit. You get quite a lot happening in that small space, a lot of stuff being tied in there, so it's got to come back. And just give that a bit of glue. Back to the wax. Well, that glue's wet. I lean into it. Right. Next stage is for the collar. I don't know how many times I've changed the way that I like to do it. Obviously, the original calls for some red saddle. I've used Fox, I've used Marabou, I've used a bit of everything. What I like to do and what I've been experimenting with is using Pettyjohn's magic tool to do a couple of different colours of Marabou. So I use these Marabou bloods. The stem's a wee bit thinner, so it makes it a wee bit easier. You can tie them on like a hackle and wind away if you want. But you've still got that thickness of that stem in there, and it can kind of come apart. So I've changed a wee bit from how I used to do it. I'm going to use, again, I'm not doing any fancy editing, so you won't see this process, but I'm going to use the magic tool and clip that Mark Pettyjohn does. I'm going to use two colours of Marabou Bloods, a kind of hot orange, and this other really kind of bright fluorescent red. And I'm going to put in some of this Foxy Tails optic fibre, which is cool stuff. And this allows me to mix all these materials into one and put it on my dubbing loop. So first thing we need to do, obviously, is put our dubbing loop in. So on your loop, go around two or three times, tie that down, and get your dubbing twister and just clip that in. Again, a wee bit of wax on that dyneema mat will help grip it. You just sit that there just now while you prepare your feathers. So, Marabou feather, I've trimmed off some of the shit from underneath. Peel the fibres, try to stroke them back so that they're kind of 90 degrees to the stem, and sit them on top of your clamp like this. Again, this, apologies, you can't see it, you just need take my word for it. And do the same with the red. Between each feather, I'm going to put a little bit of this optic fibre, as I say, just tiny little strands like this. Just laid, so I've got one feather laying on the clamp. I'm just going to lie these little strands of flash on top of that second feather, nice and sparse. Get the second feather and lie that on top of the flash. Get a wee bit tricky, but as long as the kind of strands are as close to 90 degrees, the better. Then what I'm going to do is use a bit of kind of strong wire, can't really see that, to help push these feathers down into the clamp. There we go. So this is kind of what we've got here. So I've got two colours of feather and some of that optic flash held in the clamp. So what you need to do next is knock these ends off. I'll try not to let the Marabou escape. Then transfer this over into your clamp like that. Then go back to your long bladed scissors and cut the stems away, so you're left with something like that. Then offer that up to your dubbing loop, hold it and let go. I know you can't really see that, but we've got the Marabou and the flash held together in that loop. Now I'm just going to use my finger just to push them in a wee bit, and holding it up, start to spin. Looks a wee bit of shambles just now, but well, I don't know, after 20, 30 turns or so, gently going with your double needle and start picking out these trapped feather tips. Just tease them out. A few more turns. You want to make sure that's trapped in there and it doesn't peel out when you start to wind it onto the back onto the fly. Right, so we've got a nice kind of brush made with two-tone marabou and optic fibre. So, next thing you do, wet your fingers. Get quite a lot of saliva going on this. Apologies, but if you're eating your dinner, but it helps control the hackle as you're winding it on. And this is where I find out if the camera's the phone is too close. It kind of is, but we'll give it a go. So wind on, stroking the fibres back the way as you wind. Most of you'll be familiar with this process, but this is how you do it nowadays with the whistler. And wind it right on. Hopefully you've left enough space for the put the eyes on. So take the thread round the back of the double loop, few secure turns, and snip off that waist. Now you can go back in with your needle and just tease out any trapped down marabou tips. There will be a few, but and it'll be easier when this kind of dries out because I've obviously wet it a bit. Release the clip. Good secure turns. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to attach these bead chain eyes on, whatever colour you prefer. In this case I've got red, but what I'm going to do, this Dyneema is quite slippery. I'm going to get rid of that and I'm going to tie the eyes on using this nice kind of glow bright, I think it's number 4 or something, I'm not sure. It's a nice hot orange. So I'm going to just stroke that back, offer this up, and attach it onto the fly, kind of trapping down the Dyneema at the same time. Remove your Dyneema bobbin, trim your tag end of your floss, and just neaten up a wee bit. Don't build up too much of a bump or your eyes are going to look pretty uneven. I'll move this back a touch. Eyes on top. Okay, there's not enough weight in these to affect the way the fly runs in the water. Just figure 8 wraps. And a few helicopter turns seems to be the in word for it. Now, you've still got space in there where you can put in some a kind of dubbed body, a dubbed head, another, another hackle of marabou or something like that. But I'm just going to keep it fairly simple, and just build up a head with this floss. It gives it a wee touch of weight. And this is highly UV reactive, this stuff as well. You could put a little bit of glister or something like that on. But we'll just leave it at that. Bring it in front. Just watch any edges of the eye doesn't rip your floss. Just a couple of whip finishes. For security. Knock off your thread. You've got a bit of a head under there. Again, wet fingers, stroke that back. I'm going to stick some resin in between those eyes to build that up. You can use the finer point or the thinner stuff if you want to really control this. So I've got a blob on top. Quick blast with a UV torch. Same underneath. Blast with torch. Just got to build that up a wee bit more. You can use your dummy needle to manipulate this. Ease it around the eyes, keep it away from the hook eye. Cure it. And that's pretty much it. I didn't use a big ball of Fritz or Hackle Flash in behind that hackle. You can do if you want to help keep it. You know, help keep the volume, but there's a big hollow tie, a bucktail in there that's just going to do that. So this fly's going to have plenty of pulse, plenty of movement in the water. You know, it's a deadly fly. Tie it in red, white, the silver tail's classic, but it's also really nice with gold tail, chartreuse up front. It doesn't really matter. It's a crazy effective catcher of pike. Give it a try. Enjoy it. Cheers.